Imagine a sudden blackout plunges your home into darkness. The fridge stops humming, the Wi-Fi cuts out, and you're left in silence. But with the push of a button, your car powers your entire home. That's not a science fiction. It is V2G, vehicle to grid technology. An EV isn't just a vehicle, it's a massive battery on wheels. It can even help you save money or make money by charging when electricity is cheap and discharging when prices are high. V2G, along with its variations like vehicle to load, V2L, and vehicle to home, V2H, are often used interchangeably. For simplicity, I'll use V2G to refer to the broader concept of bi-directional charging of EV. So, how does V2G work? Two key conditions must be met. First, the EV itself must support bi-directional charging. Not all electric vehicles have this capability by default. For example, most Tesla models currently do not support V2G, though future updates may introduce this feature. Second, the appropriate hardware is needed, either a bi-directional charger or a V2L adapter. For example, the Hyundai Ioniq 5 offers an optional V2L adapter that enables the EV to power external devices. It is important to note that the V2L adapter itself typically does not include an inverter. It merely serves as an interface, relying on the vehicle's built-in inverter to generate a 120-volt output. On the other hand, a bi-directional charger, as the name suggests, allows electricity to flow in both directions, enabling your EV to not only charge, but also supply power when needed. PointGuard Energy's home battery system is equipped with such bi-directional charging capabilities. They call it V2X module. As the EV industry advances, more manufacturers and charging solutions are expected to embrace V2G technology, making electric vehicles an integral part of the energy ecosystem. Let's check out two real-world examples of EVs powering homes. First up, here's a great example of a homeowner using his EV to keep the lights on during an outage. He powered his essential appliances, including lights, fridge, Wi-Fi, and heating, using a Hyundai Ioniq 5 with a V2L adapter. To make things reliable and seamless, he set up a backup generator interface and an interlock to prevent backfeeding, allowing the EV's 120-volt output to connect directly to the panel. This setup lets him easily switch between grid power and his EV whenever needed. Now, here's an even simpler approach. No extra wiring, no special setup, just plug and play. Using the same Hyundai Ioniq 5 with a V2L adapter, he simply plugged a power strip into the car's 120-volt outlet and connected his essential appliances. That's it. With a waterproof adapter, this setup can also be used for camping. If we differentiate between V2H and V2L, the first case represents V2H, vehicle to home, while the second is V2L, vehicle to load. But what about true V2G? I mean, feeding back to the grid? For now, it's mostly a waiting game. In most regions, utilities don't yet allow EVs to feed electricity back into the grid because of regulatory and management challenges. However, countries like Australia are leading the way, testing and adopting V2G technology. With the rising demand for AI computing power and the increasing share of unpredictable renewable energy sources, power grid stability is becoming a growing concern. Investing in an EV with bi-directional charging capability is a smart move. It prepares you for grid instability and reduces your dependence on traditional utilities. And if your EV doesn't support bi-directional charging yet, don't worry. A simple software update in the future may unlock this feature. Lastly, I can't wait for a world where cars can power homes, make money, and even support the grid. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss an update.